Hey, Curious. Chances are that some of you might have grown up watching Drake and Josh that aired on Nickelodeon, right? That had so many iconic moments and lines, and of course, we can't forget Oprah's number one fan, Josh. But he will not be the focus of this video, but his co-star and on-screen best friend, Drake Bell. Now, Curious, we all go through changes in our lives where we need to change and in some way rebrand ourselves, and that is exactly what Drake did and rebranded himself as a Mexican pop star. He recently changed his name on social media, and since September of last year, he's been posting nearly exclusively in Spanish on his social media. What were the changes that he made? And why are fans of the singer thinking that he has relocated to Mexico? And what is making some think that his move might not be due to career advancement? And stay with me to find out the answers to these questions. But before we continue, don't forget to hit the bell and the subscription button so you don't miss any of our videos. Just in case some of you might be confused as to who this Drake Bell guy is, I will quickly let you know. So, he was born on June 27th of 1986 in Newport Beach, California. He first started acting at the age of 5. His first televised appearance was on a 1994 episode of Home Improvement. And before his big break came in 2004, he was also featured as a performer on The Amanda Show. And then, in 2003, he and his Amanda Show co-star Josh Peck had been cast as the main characters of the Nickelodeon series titled Drake and Josh. The show started airing in January of 2004, and Bell's song Found a Way was featured as its theme song. And later, it was included on the show's soundtrack that was released at the start of 2005, and which also featured the song Highway to Nowhere that was originally performed on an episode of Zoe 101. As it was for many young stars at the time, the Nickelodeon show proved to boost his career. It gained him 3 consecutive wins at the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards for Favorite TV Actor. It also opened more doors for him to focus on his music career. On August 23rd of 2005, he released his debut album, Telegraph. It included 12 songs, which all but one, Highway to Nowhere, were written by Bell himself. And a year later, he signed with Universal Motown and released his second album, It's Only Time, in December of 2006. And once again, he wrote all the songs, but this time they were all co-written by either CJ Abraham or Michael Corcoran. Or, as they say, both. And the album reached number 81 on the Billboard's Top 200 and at number 21 on the Billboard Rock Charts. However, the album was most successful in Mexico, and there it reached number 4 in the Mexico Top 100. Drake continued acting and releasing music, and he even had a third album ready and set to be released, but it was apparently shelved and never released. That is, until the actor returned to it and made sure that it saw the light of day in 2020. Upon its long-awaited release, the album was titled The Lost Album. For the next years, Bell was busy at work both acting and music, though that did not stop him from getting in some trouble at times. And while working on his EP, a reminder, he got himself into some legal trouble with producer John Fields. The Drake and Josh star was taken to court in order to pay for songs that he allegedly never paid for, and according to a report from TMZ at the time, Fields claimed that originally Drake had agreed to pay $9,000 per song, and since he failed to pay for them, a legal action was taken with a demand for the outstanding balance of $36,000. In the end, as per TMZ, Fields got that and a bit more because the judge had ordered for Bell to pay for the songs as well as interest and the attorney's fees, which totaled to $42,787. Another thing that Drake had been known for was his famous Twitter feud with Justin Bieber, and that lasted for quite some time. And it started in 2012 when allegedly Bell's Twitter account was hacked and some rude messages were directed towards Katy Perry that were released, and soon his first tweet bashing Bieber had appeared. And this went on for the next 2 to 3 years, and while most tweets had now been deleted, a few screenshots still remained. And it even came to the point where Paris Jackson, Michael Jackson's daughter, came in Bieber's defense. Ah, the simpler times where there was no pandemic, only Bieber and Bell feuding on social media. As you can imagine, fierce and loyal as they are, Justin's fans came out to defend him and things took a nasty turn. And as you can imagine, that they get, but it seems that over time, things just sort of died down. But now, let's get to the part that truly baffled fans of the singer, as well as people online in general. While with everything that has happened in 2020, it is now even getting more difficult to surprise or shock people with anything, and it seems that some people still manage to achieve that. And here, of course, we're referring to Drake Bell's assumed relocation to Mexico. As mentioned before, the singer's second album did quite well in the charts there, and his singles also managed to pop up on the top 100 charts, so it's not really that surprising. And in 2014, he was invited by EXA FM to perform at Concerto EXA in Mexico City. Having accepted, Drake performed to a crowd of more than 50,000 people. And according to ConcertArchives.com, the singer has also performed several concerts in Mexico either solo or as a guest during festivals. Back in 2018, he released Fuego Lento, which he sings in both Spanish and English. And then in May the following year, he released a music video to accompany his single, and it turned out to be a great hit. And as of making this video, the video has over 23 million views on YouTube, as well as over 23 million streams on Spotify. And after that, he continued to release music in Spanish, and in some cases, a mix of both languages, which is more commonly known as Spanglish. His next single was No Perdamos Más Tiempo, which was a collab with Jorge Blanco. He was also invited to perform this song at a concert organized by a Mexican broadcast channel in Telehit. Last year, there were more revelations from Drake where Mexico was concerned, and in November, he has also shared a simple message on his Twitter. In Spanish, he wrote, "My social networks will now only be in Spanish, no more English," and it seems that he has kept his promise. Taking a scroll down the star's Twitter, as well as his Instagram, most of his posts seem to be in Spanish with the odd retweet or comment in English. To top it off, a few days after he decided to switch his social to Spanish, he also shared a photo of a Mexican ID card with his name, and it seems that he has chosen a more Hispanic name. Or well, just translated Bell to Spanish, because Campana, as the name that is shown on his social networks, means simply Bell, and some have debated whether the ID is real or just edited, but since we're not experts, we'll leave that decision to you. So what do you think, Curious? Is it real or not? Of course, all of these changes and the ID made the singer's fans, as well as just anyone who knew of Drake, to ask themselves the question, has he moved to Mexico? Well, here we cannot tell you. While if he is making a career in the country, it would make sense for Bell, or should we say Campana, to have moved there. Though, checking on his Twitter account, his location is still set as Los Feliz, California. So at the moment, who knows? Though, if he did make a move to Mexico, some are speculating that there might be a more serious reason behind it. And in August of this year, Drake's ex-girlfriend Melissa Lingafelt, who also goes by Jimmy Ono on her social media, accused him of abuse. And she made the allegations in a TikTok video where she said that during the course of their relationship, she endured abuse that was both verbal and physical. The two started dating in 2006 and broke up in 2009, and in her video she explained how they started seeing each other when they were only 16 years old, but that they had moved in together, and she said that the problem started about a year into their relationship and it was just verbal at the time. And speaking about it, she said, "And when I say verbal abuse, imagine the worst type of verbal abuse you could ever imagine, and that's what I got." According to Insider, the singer and actress who is now 30 stated that she doesn't care if people believe her because that is her story and her life and something that she went from. And furthermore, she revealed that it was only recently that she had realized that what she had allegedly went through is not something that all women have to go through. As per the publication, she also went on to reveal that everyone who really knew her, was her friend for the past 15 years, knows all too well what Drake had allegedly put her through. And she said that she has all the photos as well as the eyewitnesses. And to further shut down anyone who might claim that she's doing it for attention, she added, "Nobody wants attention from abuse." Mr. Bell has denied these accusations and announced that he will be seeking legal options, and according to what People magazine had published, he revealed that while their relationship ended more than a decade ago, he thinks that she still felt close enough to him last year that she was, and here we quote, "close enough to me just last year that she was comfortable reaching out to ask me to provide her with financial support during a tough time." And the singer added that he did provide her with the aid that she had asked for, but now does not know whether her behavior is a misguided quest for more money or attention, and to end it, he announced that he's seeking legal aid. So curious, what do you think about Drake rebranding himself as a Mexican pop star? Do you believe that he has truly moved to Mexico? And in your opinion, if he has, was that a career move or is it related to the accusations? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and I will see you again soon.